Hello, welcome, this is Jane. This is the free trial video in my CalligraFée online art school. And today we're going to be looking at a little illuminated letter done very simply with a few little simple motifs on it to bring it to life. So you'll need paper, pencil, it's a nice soft drawing pencil if you have one, eraser, and some colored pencils. So if you have all that to hand, let's get started. Okay, here's the basic form of the letter we're going to be doing. This is called a versal letter, and it's an alphabet I just love because it's so soft. Look at these lovely rounded lines. There's nothing straight. There's no straight lines. And I like this in this alphabet because I find these curves, they kind of invite you to draw and continue and imagine other designs that you can put on the letter. If you compare this with even earlier, before the Middle Ages, in the ancient world, there was a form of letters that you're going to recognize very easily called Roman capitals. I'm just going to draw one a bit basic here. That's a real A, a real Roman capital A. And these little feet on it are called serifs. They have little serifs. You'll recognize these even from typefaces on the computer because they still exist. And there's a little serif up here, just going to the left, not to the right, just to the left. That's a real Roman capital A. And you see how straight and military and disciplined this letter is. And then in the Middle Ages, we soften it because these are versals. Versals means they were the letters that were at the beginning of verses, at the beginning of chapters, and you want to decorate them a bit more. You want them to shine and be a bit more colorful. So this is the form that was developed. So let's do this together. Come down onto your paper now with a soft pencil. Look at this, is a 2B I'm using, B for black. So it erases easily. We want a pencil you can erase simply because you're going to be changing your mind and adding and subtracting things all the time. So you want a pencil you can erase. And we're not going to press hard on it. We're going to do a little lines like this. I'm doing this line here. See how I sketch it? I'm not pressing hard. And I sketch the other side. And if I'm not happy with the shape I've made, imagine I'd started too wide like that and I'd come in. Well, then I take my handy dandy kneaded eraser. I love these erasers. It's not putty, it's an eraser. And I can erase without any crumbs. And then I come back and do my line where it should be. If I get that in place. I like starting with this part of the letter because then I'm solid and in place. I know where I am. Then I'm going to go and do the roof, the top bit, a bit curved, and it comes down and it goes up a little bit. It's not a straight line. It's not too curvy, but it's not straight. I'll just leave that hanging for the moment. Very soft, kind of sketchy lines. Now we're going to do this part that comes down. You see the shape of this letter is kind of a straight line here, a diagonal line there, little top part, and where the bar was on the Roman letter. That's kind of the basic shape. So this part of the letter, this diagonal part, let's make it a bit softer though. It's not a straight line. It bulges out a bit to the left, comes down and around, goes much lower than the other side. Whoops, down like that. Soft kind of a slide. And then come back to where you started. And this is kind of a teardrop shape. And gradually wider and wider and wider until you get to about where the first bit ended, and then you curve it in. And take your time doing that. Get a nice round curve. These are roughs. We are just learning to do this letter. So don't mind if you make mistakes, if you don't like your form. You have a sheet of paper, do it again. Do it 2 times, 3 times, 10 times, till you get a form you like. You have to practice. Around, a bit rounded. I might take out a little bit of that pencil because I've got too many pencil lines now. How's that? And then I put on the rounded foot here. We're almost got the letter in place now. Now, instead of the bar, I like to do kind of a branch that grows up out of this tree, or it could come from the other side. You see, you get a lot of freedom with me. There's a basic form underlying the shape, but
afterwards it's for you to invent and adapt. And these are very elastic letters. You can change them a lot. So I'm going to take this curve and I'm going to sweep around that way. So that'll be the bar of the A. Look, it's quite a fluid shape. Now, as I said, these little bits that come off rounded invite you to decorate them. So as I was saying, this is kind of like a leaf. Let's keep with the idea of leaves. Here's a leaf that doesn't exist. I like imaginary leaves. We don't have to do a leaf that exists in nature. We could do. Later in the art school online, we'll be looking at real drawing and doing realistic drawing. But this isn't. This is just fantasy drawing. So what about a little heart that in fact is a leaf? It starts with a heart and it turns into a leaf. I like to add these. I sometimes do them. I add these a lot to my illuminations. I do a little heart shape that isn't closed. You see, I don't close the center. And I leave a little bit white, and I color in this with a colored pencil or paint. And you see this little leaf motif? That's a nice little design. You can even extend the little end of it, make it turn. Makes a pretty little leaf. So that's leaf one. What about leaf two? Come down here, and I'm going to take a swirly line. You see, I don't like straight lines much. You're realizing that. And I'm going to do two little lines that grow out of it. And these are the veins of the leaf. And this is a leaf with three parts. So let's do like the heart. One heart there. This is a bit heart-shaped. One heart shape here. And a longer heart shape. Zoop, zoop. And that's a different kind of leaf. And you can vary these. You can do them really quickly, and they can change shape a lot. This is in pencil, luckily, so I can change things if I need to take an emery board and make that a bit smoother. Oh, there you go. Like sanding down a bit of a part that you don't like. So you can develop these leaves, do them any way you like. So where can we add these leaves on our letter? Let's put the little heart-shaped leaf. You see, you can decide yourself. This is just my idea for this letter. I could do one of my little heart-shaped leaves there, for example. How's that? I could do another one growing off of this foot. I could even turn it around a bit. See, continue that in a nice fluid shape and do your little heart-shaped leaf there. How about that? I'm pressing a little bit harder when I'm sure of the form. Otherwise, do it very lightly. Now we've got this longer bit. Maybe we do one of the three-pointed leaves there. So do your little veins and go one. Soft shapes, two, a bit longer. Three, come back in. And we can always go back and tidy up that line a bit. Now this is just a rough. This isn't a finished design. I'm just getting ideas on this rough drawing paper. When you're going to do a finished project, like we'll do in the first class on the art school online, then we'll use beautiful art paper and we'll do a finished one. But this is just to get us started. Here's my two little veins there. And do this a bit smaller. One, two, three. Oh, it's a nice little leaf. Maybe I've got enough leaves. Maybe with this corner, I'll just do a little swirly-whirly. Or one there. How about that? Now we've got a beautiful little A in place. Now at this point, if you haven't made too much of a mess with your pencil lines, you could leave it just in pencil and then we'll color it in. Or if you'd like, you could take a felt marker, a very fine felt marker, and do the outline solid. Now you know where it is. Then take your eraser and get rid of all the pencil, and then it's clean to color in with colored pencil or with paint. But this is just our rough, so we're going to just leave it like that. Now I have to think of colors. I like blue very much, so imagine I have a blue. Is that a nice blue? I'll try this blue. I have pale blue there. Now, there are three terms I want to share with you about colors. The first is primary colors. You've probably heard this. What are the three primary colors? There's blue, red, and yellow. I don't know how pale this yellow is, but this is meant to be yellow. Blue, red, yellow. Those are the primary colors. Then there's secondary colors. Secondary colors are when you mix the primary colors. So if I mix blue and yellow, I get, yes, green. If I mix yellow and red, I get orange. Do I have an orange? Yes, there's an orange. And blue and red gives us purple. I don't know if I have a good purple. Oh, yes, that's nice. Imagine these colors being mixed as paints. Primary colors, secondary colors. And the third term is complementary colors. Complement, not like you pay someone a compliment, but complete something, complementary. And that is when you take a primary color like blue, and its complement is the other two primary colors mixed together. So that's the secondary color. Those are complementary colors, blue and orange. Or you could do yellow and violet or purple, red and green. Those are complements. They're the primary color plus the mixture of the other two primary colors. And we use this a lot in artwork, especially in publicity art and graphic design, because when you use complementary colors, it makes your work sparkle. It shines out a bit. You can use other colors as well. It's just a technique, but it kind of gives a special zizz to your artwork. So let's try that for this letter. I'm going to take the blue that I like, and I'm going to color in, but lightly. I'm not pressing hard. I'll show you why later. I'm just doing a background color, very, very pale on the two parts of my A. You could use different colors of blue, dark and light, and turquoise. And there's so many blues. And in our art school, we'll be using paints as well, gouaches. So then you have lots of possibilities of blues. Now, complementary color. Well, I put the orange. The complement of blue is orange. So let's do my little leaves. There and there. And I'm just thinking as I'm doing this, you know, I think it needs animals. I don't have animals on this letter. I just have leaves. I'm going to take my pencil back for a minute, and I'm going to add a couple of my very favorite animals. You're going to say, oh, she lives in France, and I know in France they eat these animals. But no, I don't eat these animals. These are my friends. A little snail. Why do I like snails so much? Because for an artist that works slowly and calmly, a snail is a nice animal that goes slowly and enjoys. Go slowly and enjoy. That's the motto. And another animal that I like very much, the leaves have made me think of that, is a butterfly that doesn't exist, that I've invented. It has a little body, and its wings are made of hearts. Look at this. Heart there, and then two little hearts, even smaller. Isn't that an adorable butterfly? It's a heartafly. So could I put my heartafly in somewhere? Yes, I think I'm going to take my handy dandy pointed eraser. Isn't this wonderful? Look at this, it's a pencil that's really an eraser. And I'm gonna take off a little bite out of my letter. I love this eraser, but it does leave crumbs. Not a problem. Because now I'm going to put my little heartafly, my little butterfly there, with its first wing here and its little wings there, and then it's flying in front of the letter. I'll go back and fix a little bit of my blue around it. Very nice. I might make his body, is that red or orange? Let's take the orange, stick with our orange because that's the complement of the blue. I might even make my little swirly go slowly and enjoy snails. I think they're very decorative animals. And with my orange, I've pressed really softly, very light orange there, and that allows me to go a little harder with the color to do the outline. So it, you see, I'm getting the little swirl then. You can still see the crayon through it a bit, or the pencil through it, but that's not a problem. And I could even do the outline of my little leaves. Pressing a bit harder now. I could do the center a bit orange. Outline, outline. Come back to the blue. Let's take a darker blue and do the outline of my blue letter. So I cover my pencil line a bit. This is just a rough. This is just to get some ideas going. If I were going to really do a project with this little letter, maybe I would do it in paint. But this is giving me an idea for the colors. So I'm doing it a bit darker. Do my little swirly-whirly in blue. This side, down and around. Now I know where that line is, so I can go with a bit more confidence around. I could even make this line a bit thicker if I wanted to, like a frame. But for now, that's right. And up, this is the bar of the A. Now, in heraldic art, you know, the art of coats of arms and shields and heraldry, they often, with their leaves or drapery, they have two different colors in the same design. So let's do that. Let's have one side of the leaf blue and one side orange, just like in heraldic art. Just an idea. You can do it differently in yours if you wish. In fact, of course you can use other colors as well, but I like not to put too many colors into a small design, the whole rainbow in every design. Come back to your orange, and let's do the orange side of the leaf, a little bit darker than my little heart leaves. It's already turning into a very pretty letter. Around, color it in, even if you can see a bit of the pencil line through it, not a problem. You can go a bit darker over that. If we had the outline in black, we would have erased the pencil lines. What about the heart of fly? Let's go back to yellow, maybe, for that. We'll just have a different color going on there. I like a pale color there for the leaf, for the wings of the butterfly or heart of fly, because then I can go back maybe with orange or red or something and put a little bit of a vein in the middle. That looks pretty. That gives like a little shadow. Maybe I keep the yellow going for my snails. But this is for you to decide. You're the artist. You can change colors. And because I've done the blue so softly there, I can now go back and add a design in the middle of the blue, a little bit stronger, as we were talking of hearts all over this lovely letter. Let's put a heart in there. You see, now I'm pressing a bit harder, and that's going to show up against the pale blue. There, you have to be sure of yourself, because you can't do a rough and erase it. You could even do some little spots. Look how pretty this is turning into a very pretty illuminated letter, even with simple little motifs. What do you think? You could always put leaves around it, or colors swirling around it, or a little bit of a yellow or something to highlight one side of it. My problem is to stop. I just want to keep going and keep adding things. Make it shine. That's what illuminations are. They're letters that shine, like luminous is in the word. So that's already a beautiful letter. Here's a couple of other ideas. The same form. There I did the same kind of letter, you see, with my double colors on the other sides, little leaves. And there I used two colors on center, a light blue and a dark blue. And imagine if you had colored pencils that were also watercolor pencils, you know, the ones you can add water to afterwards and paint over. You paint over that. Mine aren't, they're just ordinary colored pencils. But if you had the watercolor pencils, you paint over it with water and the colors would blend like a gradated color change, which would be quite pretty. And there I did a little loop with the leaf. Yeah. Here's another one. There I did the outline in the black and erased my pencil lines. So that makes a different kind of look, a bit heavier. And here's another one with an outline in black, even heavier again. And there, I left a bit my complementary colors. You've got pinks and yellows and greens, and I went a bit madder. But I put the little leaves in the background. I'll put that with the first letter and see, then you can see all of them together, perhaps. So you have quite a choice, even with the same basic form. Look at all the things you can do to decorate that letter. So there's your first illuminated letter A.
Well, very good. I hope you enjoyed that little lesson together. Now, if you'd like to continue and join the online school, please click on the link below. And I'm looking forward to sharing with you again soon and having lots of fun. And don't forget, go slowly and enjoy. See you soon.